Good morning, YouTube. So while I was trying to get one or both of these full graphic smart controllers working, I was trying to find a test program that was maybe a little less complicated than trying to build the whole Marlin firmware, because I didn't know if I was building the Marlin firmware correctly. The Marlin firmware uses the Arduino U8 glib graphics library. There's support for the chip that's used on here. I think it's an ST7920, if I remember right. And I'll show you a little bit later. We'll look at the code in the Arduino IDE. And it turns out getting this controller and that board, this is the Roomba board, there's no built-in support in the U8 glib code, at least anything predefined in that code to support this board. Okay, here we got the graphics display, and let me get the power here. And there we have the graphics test example from the U8 glib code running. We'll switch over to the PC screen, and I'll show you what I had to do in the Arduino IDE to get this working.
Yeah, so as I mentioned, I was trying to find a simple test program for the full graphic smart controller board that I had. So since the Marlin firmware used this U8 glib, which is the universal 8-bit graphics library for the Arduino, I thought I could use some of those test programs. Right out of the box, you don't know which particular pin setting or constructor to use for that. I just tried a couple of them and nothing worked. So I looked on YouTube and I found this fellow Z Production that had posted a video a couple of years ago using an Arduino Mega, which is right here, with the ramps board and one of these 128 by 64 pixel LCD controllers. That's the main difference then between the RUMBA board that I have and the ramps board. The ramps board is basically a 3D printer shield that goes on top of an Arduino Mega. The RUMBA board has the Mega chip and all of that support function built into the controller board, so it's kind of like an Arduino Mega plus a ramps board. So that's what I'm using, is the RUMBA. I couldn't find anything directly related to that, but I figured this ramps board was pretty close. So at this fellow, he did the same thing I did. He took that and that and that, plugged them all together, and he tried going in here to some of the graphics test code and didn't work. Here's some of the constructors. You got to pick one of these. So apparently these smart controllers use this ST7920 controller chip, but even then there's dozens of constructor calls that all have different parameters. Like he's showing here, how are the pins on the Mega board hooked to the pins on the ramp board, and how are the pins on the ramp board hooked to the pins on the controller board. What he ended up doing was making himself a little table going from the Mega to the pins on the LCD and trying to figure out which pins related to which. And then he broke out his ohmmeter and tested continuity between all the pins on the pin header. So the ramps board uses this external pin header. The RUMBA board has this built in. You know, what he came up with was a full breakdown of what pins on the Mega board were mapped to which pins on the LCD. And so he went in and he created this special constructor line with a 23, 17, and 16 parameters. I guess that's for your S-clock, MOSI, and chip select CS pins. And so I went and plugged that in and it didn't work. And I didn't really want to go through all that much work, you know, ohming out all the pins and whatnot to get this working. But what I did was I went down through his comments, and there was this fellow down here Obet Ball, if that's pronounced right. He had a comment here, and he was wondering how he got these pins. He didn't really show how he pulled these out of the data table that he had collected. And then this fellow posted a follow-up comment. He figured out that this pin 23 was the ST7920 clock pin, data pin, and CS pin. And then he's also mentions up here that he's working with Marlin. And then he has this second set of pound defines here, where he calls out these things LCD pins D4, pins enabled, and LCD pins RS. Okay, so I came over here to the Marlin source code. So over here is all of the other files that are in the Marlin source code. And what they have is this whole list of these pins underscore, and then there's all of these different 3D printer controller boards, dozens and dozens of them. And there's this one for pins underscore ramps, and here's this pins underscore RUMBA. So if we take a look at the ramps pin header here, here's your graphical RepRap world graphical LCD, and here's this guy's three pins that he used: pins, LCD pins D4, pins enabled, and pins RS. Those are the exact same things he called out here. These are essentially the definitions that the Marlin firmware uses. And so what I thought was, how about we come over here to pins underscore RUMBA, which is what I have, and there they are. Those three same defines, pins RS, pins enabled, and pins D4. So what I did, I came over here, let's go to graphics test, and I added this comment here. You go to your Marlin pins underscore, and then whatever board you're using, and look for what's assigned to LCD underscore pins underscore D4, and that goes in here. So in my case, I used 18, 42, and 19. And as you saw at the beginning of the video, graphics test works. And then I went just to check that out. I put the same code into the FPS demo. And at the end of the video, I'll cut in a screenshot of the FPS demo test program running. So anyway, if you're trying to get your RepRap discount full graphics smart controller working with something like a RAMPS or a RUMBA board, or probably any of these boards that are supported in the Marlin firmware, have a look at these files and then see if you can find these pound defines in there. And that'll probably tell you what pin assignments you have to put in here for your U8 glib constructor call. So hopefully that helps. If you have any questions, post up in the comment section down below. I'll put some other related videos over here on the left side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching. And now the FPS graphics test program.